ASMR world here. We're all good. So, today, I bring you episode one of our football profile series. I told you last week who'd be, and I'm sticking to. So, every Sunday, apart from when I'm on holiday, we will cover one football club or one player famous for their football. And we'll go through their history. Today, in episode one, we're going to cover Pele. Yes, the great Pele, the Brazilian footballer. So, let's get started. United. Brazil under President Jânio Quadros had declared Pele an official national treasure the year before to prevent him from being transferred out of the country. Pele won his first major title with Santos in 1958 as the team won the Campeonato Paulista. Pele would finish the tournament as top scorer with 58 goals, a record that stands today. A year later, he would help the team earn their first victory in the Torneo Rio Sao Paulo with a 3-0 win over Vasco da Gama. Pele scored 33 goals to help his team regain the Paulista trophy, but lost out on the Rio Sao Paulo tournament after finishing 8th place. In the 1960 season, Pele scored 47 goals. Fucking hell. In 1964, the Copa Libertadores, Santos were beaten in both legs of the semi-finals by Independiente. The club won the Campeonato Paulista with Pele scoring another 34 goals. Where are we going here? The club did. This proved to be the start of a decline as Santos failed to retain the Torneo Rio Sao Paulo in 1966. Pele and Santos also failed to retain the Taça Brasil as Pele's goals were not enough to prevent a 9-4 defeat by Cruzeiro, led by Tostão in the final series. The club, however, did win the Campeonato Paulista in 1967-68-69. On 19th of November 1969, Pele scored his 1,000th goal in all competitions. It was a highly anticipated moment in Brazil. The goal, popularly dubbed O Milissimo, the 1,000th, occurred in a match against Vasco da Gama, when Pele scored from a penalty kick at the Maracana Stadium. Imagine that. All the goals he scored in his career and the 1,000th goal was a penalty. How boring. So, that was in 1969. And he started playing in when? Let's have a look. So, 1969 scored 1,000th goal. Okay, 1956, he signed a professional contract. 13 years later, he scored 1,000 goals. Not bad going. Now, where are we up to? Pele states that his most memorable goal was scored at Rua Javari Stadium on a Campeonato Paulista match against São Paulo rival club Atlético Juventus on 2nd of August 1959. There's enough video footage of the match. Pele asked that a computer animation be made up of the specific goal. In March 1961, Pele scored the goal worthy of a plaque, against Fluminense at the Maracana. Pele received the ball on the edge of his own penalty area and ran the length of the field, eluding opposition players with feints before sticking the ball beyond the goalkeeper. A plaque was commissioned with a dedication to the most beautiful goal in the history of the Maracanã. In 1967, the two factions involved in the Nigerian Civil War agreed to a 48-hour ceasefire so they could watch Pele play an exhibition match in Lagos. During his time in Santos, Pele played alongside many gifted players, including Zito, Pepe and Coutinho. The latter partnered him in numerous 1-2 players, attacks and goals. He moved to New York Cosmos after the 1974 season. His 19th season with Santos, Pele retired from Brazilian club football, although he continued to occasionally play for Santos in official competitive matches. 2 years later, he came out of semi-retirement to sign with the New York Cosmos of the North American Soccer League for the 1975 season. Though well past his prime at this United States, hoping to fuel the same kind of awareness in the Dominican Republic. He and the Cosmos team played in an exhibition match against Haitian team Violet AC in the Santo Domingo Olympic Stadium on the 3rd of June 1976, where over 25,000 fans watched him score a winning goal in the last seconds of the match, leading the Cosmos to a 2-1 victory. He led the Cosmos in the 1977 NASL Championship in his third and final season with the club. On the 1st of October 1977, Pele closed out his career in an exhibition match between Cosmos and Santos. Santos arrived in New York after previously defeating Pele's rumbling, the Seattle Sounders, in New York 2-0. The match was played in front of a sold-out crowd at Giants Stadium and was televised in the United States on ABC's Wide World of Sports, as well as throughout the world. Pele's father and wife both attended the match, as well as Muhammad Ali and Bobby Moore. Not bad crowd. His international career. His first match for Brazil was a 2-1 defeat against Argentina in 1957 at the Maracanã. In that match, he scored his first goal for Brazil aged 16. At 9 months, he remains the youngest goal scorer for his country. In the 1958 World Cup, he arrived in Sweden, sidelined by an injury. Upon his return from the treatment room, his colleagues stood together and insisted upon his selection. His first match was against USSR, the old Russia, and Soviet Union. In the third match of the first round of the 1958 FIFA World Cup, where he gave the assist to Vava's second goal, he was the youngest player of that tournament and at that time the youngest ever to play in a World Cup. Against France in the semi-final, Brazil was leading 2-1 at half-time, and then Pele scored a hat-trick, becoming the youngest in the World Cup history to do so. On the 29th of June 1958, Pele became the youngest player to play in a World Cup final match, aged 17 years and 249 days. He scored 2 goals in that final as Brazil beat Sweden 5-2 in Stockholm. His first goal, where he flicked the ball over a defender before falling into the corner of the net, was selected as one of the best goals in the history of the World Cup. Following Pele's second goal, Swedish player Sigvard Parning would later comment, "When Pele scored the 5th goal in that final, I have to be honest and say I felt like applauding." When the match ended, Pele passed out on the field and was revived by Garinka. He then recovered and was compelled by the victory to weep as he was being congratulated by his teammates. He finished the tournament with 6 goals in 4 matches played, tied for 2nd place behind record breaker Just Fontaine, and was named best young player of the tournament. It was in the 1958 World Cup that Pele began wearing the jersey with number 10 on the back. The event was the result of disorganisation. The leaders of the Brazilian Federation did not send the shirt numbers of players, and it was up to FIFA to choose the number 10 shirt. So Pele, who was a substitute on the occasion, was given the number 10. South American Championship. Pele also played in the South American Championship in the 1959 competition. He was named best player of the tournament and scored 8 goals as Brazil came second, despite being unbeaten in the tournament. He scored in 5 of Brazil's games, of their 6 games, including 2 goals against Chile and a hat-trick against Paraguay. In the 1962 World Cup, he started as being rated as the best player in the world. Pele assisted a goal against Chile and then scored the second one after running past 4 defenders to go 2-0 up. He then injured himself in the next game against Czechoslovakia, attempting a long-range shot. This would keep him out the rest of the tournament and forced coach Aimor Moreira to make his only lineup change of the tournament. The substitute was Amarildo, who performed well for the rest of the tournament. However, it was Garinka, who would take the leading role Czechoslovakia in the final in Santiago. In 1966, Pele was the most famous footballer in the world during the 66 World Cup in England. Brazil fielded some world champions in Gringa, Gilmar, Djalma, Santos, with the addition of other stars like Jorginho, Tostão, Gerson, leading to high expectations for them. Brazil was eliminated in the first round, playing only three matches. The World Cup was marked, among other things, for brutal fouls on Pele that left him injured by the Bulgarian and Portuguese defenders. Pele scored the first goal from a free kick against Bulgaria, becoming the first player to score in three successive World Cups. But due to his injury, a result of persistent fouling by the Bulgarians, he missed the second game against Hungary. Brazil lost that game, and Pele, although still recovering, was brought back for the last crucial match against Portugal at Goodison Park in Liverpool. In 1970, in the World Cup, Pele was called to the national team early in 1969. He refused at first, but then accepted and played in six World Cup qualifying matches, scoring six goals. The 1970 World Cup in Mexico was expected to be Pele's last. Brazil's squad for the tournament featured major changes in relation to the 66 squad. Players like Gringa, Nilton Santos, Valder, Pereira, Djalma Santos and Gilmar had already retired. However, Brazil's 1970 World Cup squad, which included players like Pele, Rivelino, Jorginho, Gerson, Carlos Alberto Torres, Tostão, Clodoaldo, is often considered to be the greatest football team in history. The front five are Jorginho, Pele, Gerson, Tostão and Rivelino together created an attacking momentum, with Pele having a central role in Brazil's way to the final. All of Brazil's matches in the tournament, except the final, were played in Guadalajara, and in the first match against Czechoslovakia, Pele gave Brazil a 2-1 lead by controlling Gerson's long pass with his chest and then scoring. Against Romania, Pele scored two goals, with Brazil winning by a final score of 3-2 in the quarterfinals against Peru. Brazil won 4-2 with Pele assisting to Tostão for Brazil's third goal. In the semi-final match, they played Uruguay for the first time since the 1950 World Cup final. Jorginho put Brazil 2-1 up, and Pele assisted Rivelino for the 3-1. During the match, Pele made one of his most famous plays. Tostão played the ball for Pele to collect, which Uruguay's goalkeeper, took notice of and ran off his line to get the ball before Pele. However, Pele got there first and fooled the keeper with a feint by not touching the ball, causing it to roll past the keeper's left, while Pele went to the keeper's right. Pele ran around the goalkeeper to retrieve the ball and took a shot while turning towards the goal, but he turned in excess as he shot and the ball drifted just wide of the post. How amazing would that be to see? We need to check that on YouTube at some point, guys. Brazil played Italy in the final at the Azteca Stadium in Mexico City. Pele scored the opening goal with a header over Italian defender Tarcio Bergniche. He then made assists on Brazil's third goal, scored by Jorginho, and the fourth finished by Carlos Alberto. The last goal of the game is often considered the greatest team goal of all time because it involved all the team's outfield players. The play culminated after Pele made a blind pass that went into Carlos Alberto's running trajectory. He came running from behind and struck the ball to score. Brazil won the match 4-1. The defender, Pele to the mid-calf, said afterwards, "I told myself before the game, he's made of skin and bones, just like everyone else, Well, I was wrong. Pele's last international match was on the 18th of July 1971 against Yugoslavia in Rio de Janeiro. With Pele on the field, the Brazilian team scored. Oh, the Brazilian team's record was 67 wins, 14 draws, 11 losses. Brazil never lost a match while fielding Pele and Garrincha. Let's see if we can find out his scoring record. Okay. Right then. So, for Santos. So it's time 56 winters 1974, first season, 1 goal, 2nd, 41 goals, 51 goals, 33, sorry, 1 goal for the first one, then 41, 66, 51, 33, 55, 37, 36, 37, 54, 13, 26, 28, 38, 11, 9, 14, 30, in his last season, 10. He got 619 goals in 638 games. And that was in just in domestic competitions. And then during those same seasons, he got a fair few other goals in different competitions. So altogether, I don't bloody know. It's difficult to work out. Okay. So it was in all competitions. So 619 goals in 638 games. For New York Cosmos, 15 goals in his first, 26 in his second, 23 in his third, 64 goals in 107 games. For Brazil, well, I can't actually find out his total goals for Brazil. I don't think it's on here. Oh, here we go. For Brazil, 95 goals in 114 games. For New York Cosmos, 65 in 111. For Santos, 1,091 in 1,116 games. Altogether, he played 1,366 matches in his career. He's got 1,283 goals. That's a bit shit, really, isn't it? I mean, he went like, what, 76, 83 games without goals. That's terrible. Joking, guys. Pele. One of the greatest players to ever live, Pele, Maradona. Do you put Ronaldo in that category now, though? My eyes are so mashed up, guys. Sorry about this. Do you put Messi and Ronaldo in there now? Is it really between the four? Messi, Maradona, Pele, Ronaldo. I'd say so. I don't know how you pick. I think, in my opinion, or maybe it's because we are in this day and age and we're not back then, I think you have to give it to Messi and Ronaldo. They are playing in such... I know the pitches were terrible back then, I get that. But the players were half as good as they are these days. I mean, Pele got over 1,000 goals in Brazil. You know, it's a pretty bang average football league over there. So in that respect, he hasn't done it in the Champions League. He didn't do it with Real Madrid or Barcelona. I've been seeing Ronaldo half for so long. And what else? Maradona, he did it in Europe, but so maybe Maradona better than Pele. I don't know, I'm not the person to say that. I've only ever seen highlights of Pele play, but yeah, what a fantastic player he was. But I don't think we can ever judge or make a decision on the best player ever. You got George Best as well, who is a United fan, he got put in there, and Duncan Edwards, who we never got to see enough of. I didn't see him at all. I was away from born. We died in the Munich air disaster. And Bobby Charlton said he would have been way better than he said, and also hooping as good as Pele and Maradona. I'm sure he said that in the past. I could be wrong. I'm pretty sure he has. But none of us got to see him. I'm sure, obviously, there are people out there who did see Duncan Edwards play, but they're all getting on a bit now. Anyway, I'm Ollie. Ollie's ASMR World. I hope you enjoyed the video. Next week. Saying which club out of the three you'd like me to do, and the one with the most